Good morning, children. Good morning, Makra. Today, we will revise our third lesson, that is Arun's new friend. Which is the third lesson? Arun's new friend. It has been such a long time that we have learned this lesson. So, today let us revise and next class onwards, we will start with the next new lesson. Okay. So, I am bored. Bored. Scowled Arun. His mother looked at him in exasperation after the hustle and bustle of Delhi. She had bought Arun would like the peace of Vilaspur, a tiny town in Chhattisgarh. Yet Arun was complaining non-stop about boredom. Arun was getting so much of bore. He was all the time complaining. He was angry. I am bored. He was complaining. What he was doing? He was complaining all the time. His mother was looking at him with the exasperation. Exasperation means she was so sad. She was so angry. She was so upset because she had bought him from a busiest city, Delhi, to the small town of Vilaspur, which is in Chhattisgarh. But here also, he was continuously complaining about his boredom. If you complain about your boredom to your mother, your father, for every minute, how they feel? They get angry, right? The same way, Arun's mother was also feeling so sad. She was upset, she was angry, but she could not express more to him. And then what happens? With nothing here to do, Arun decided to take the mongrel Moti for a walk. Arun had to admit the walk to the shady mango orchard was lovely. They had barely stepped there when a loud bellow stopped them in their tracks. And then Arun had taken his dog Moti. Mongrelo is a kind of dog. Its name was Moti. He took him for the walk, and they entered into the mango orchard, means mango field. And then they stopped in between when they heard the sound of someone shouting. Bellow means when they heard someone shouting, they stopped. And where do you think you are going, my dears? Arun looked around. He was surprised to see a pair of short clad legs dangling in front. Looking up, Arun saw a pair of spectacles glinting back at him through the dense leaves of the tree. Moti uttered a little oof and wagged his tail. Oh, Moti knew that person. It means when he heard the sound. Where are you going, dears? Yelli hogtidira makle? Athwa yelli hogtidira aatmiyare? Anta keldaga, what did Arun do? He lifted his head and saw there were two legs were hanging, and he could see a glimpsing glass. Means a person was sitting on a branch of tree hiding under the leaves. Barely he could see his face. When he heard the sound, he looked up, and then with the Arun, even Moti looked up, and it started to bark. It just barked once and started. What it started? It started to move his tail. Yes, wagged his tail. Wagged means moving from one side to another side. You know, when we go to some relative or friend's house, if they have a dog, if that dog knows us, what it does? It doesn't shout, bark at us. Instead of barking, what it does? It makes a small moving like dearly sound, and then it waggles its tail. Right? And then also, Moti has brought you here. said the owner of the spectacles, who jumped down from the tree. Arun looked up with interest and saw a very fit old man, between 60 to 70, with a shining pate encircled by a cloud of snow, white hair. Arun liked him immediately. Then that person jumped from the tree and said, "Oh, Modi had brought you here." Then Arun was surprised. How come he knows? And that person was so young and energetic. His age was between 60 to 70, but he was fit and energetic. And then the old man held out his hand. "Pleased to meet you, sir. Colonel Phukan here. Your good morning, sir. Arun Raghavansh." Then Rajvansh. Then what that person did, he held the Arun's hand and said, "Ki, pleased to meet you, sir. I am Mr. Colonel Phukan. I am Colonel Phukan." And then what Arun did, he also introduced himself. "Very good morning, sir. Myself is Arun Rajvansh." Then they become the friend. Then what happens? He led Arun inside the neat cottage and hollered, "Chotu Singh, look who's here." In loped a magnificent Alistian. He made straight for Moti. Arun backed away a little. "Don't worry," Colonel Phukan said. "They know each other." And then what that colonel did, he held Arun's hand and took him to his cottage. As he entered into the cottage, he called his dog. He also had a dog, and he told him, look here who's come. When he saw the dog, one more dog coming from the house, coming from inside the house, what the Arun did, he stepped back. Andre hindak sarkontane. Then Mr. Colonel says, "Don't worry, they both know each other. Yeradu naigalu obbarnobru gurthiditave. So don't worry." Then Arun and Colonel Phukan spent time talking and getting to know each other. "Okay, sir, I have to go now, mother." Arun got up at last to go. And then they both sat for a longer time, and they were talking about each other. ಅವರಿಬ್ಬರು ಒಬ್ಬರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬರು ತಮ್ಮ ಒಬ್ಬರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರು. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಅರುಣ್ ಸೇಸ್, "ಓಕೆ ಸರ್, ನೌ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಲಿವ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವೇಟಿಂಗ್." ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಲಂಚ್ ಅರುಣ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಮದರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾನಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್. ಹಿ ಕೇಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾನಿ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕರ್ನಲ್ ಫುಕಾನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಡ್ ಅಲೋನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಾಟೇಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸನ್ ಅವಿನಾಶ್ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ US. ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ರೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಮ್ ವೈಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಲಂಚ್, he tells about Mr. Phukan to his mother and grandmother. Then grandmother says that Mr. Phukan stays alone in that cottage and his only son lives in US. Though the next few days had to be spent in bed, they were the happiest for the two. But alas, too soon it was time for Arun and his mother to leave for Delhi. They came to say bye to the old man. After the days, 1 week, 15 days, when the days passed, then the time came for Arun and his mother to go back to the Delhi. Then what they both did, they both came to the Mr. Colonel Phukan, and then they said bye and they wished him good luck for the next upcoming days. "So time to leave," he said in his usual loud voice. "Yes, sir." Arun started to say something when he was interrupted. Then the colonel says, "Oh, now it is time to say goodbye," in his loud voice. You know how army men speak? They speak always in a loud voice. Then Arun says, "Yes, sir." And he wanted to say something, but he was interrupted. Interrupted andre avanna ಅವನ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿ ಅವ್ರು ಬೇರೊಬ್ಬರು ಮಾತಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡೋದು. ದೆನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಫೇವರ್ ಸನ್, ಕುಡಂಟ್ ಯು ಮೇಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ನಾನು ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೀಡ್. ದ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಐಸ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಓವರ್. ದೆನ್ The old man says, "Can you say Nanu instead of saying old man or dad uncle?" Then that time the Mr. Colonel was having tears in his eyes. He wanted Arun to call him as Nanu. Nanu means Ajja. Okay. A lump seemed to have appeared out of nowhere, right in the middle of Arun's throat. "Yes, sir," mean Nanu. "Yes, of course. And you will come here next summer too." "Yes. And you won't call our lovely Vilaspur boring again." "Of course not, Nanu. How can it be when you are here?" Then Arun calls him as Nanu. "Of course, Mister. Of course, sir." Then again he says, "I mean to say Nanu." Then he says, "Okay. So next summer, in the next v summer vacations, you are coming back to the Vilaspur. And this time, next time, you will not complain that Vilaspur is boring." Then Arun says, No, it will not be so bored because you are here, Nanu." And then they become as a relatives, means not with the blood relatives, but by the heart. Okay, so this was about the whose this lesson was about whom? This was about Arun's new friend. Sometimes when we go to the vacations, to our grandmother's house or mama's house, there with the neighbors, we make a friendship. And sometimes in the when we become so close, we start calling each other as auntie, uncle, bhaiya, didi. So these are the relations which we develop in a friendship. But whether it is not a blood relation, but it is from the heart. So whenever you are meeting new people, you have to meet them with lots of love and respect, which builds the relation and it shows the humanity. It allows the humanity to develop and create new relations to be a human. Okay, children? So this is the third lesson. We just revised it. Next class, we will start with the next lesson. Take care. Bye.